This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Tuesday the 11th of June. I'm Samira Pickup. GSLP confirms Albert Isola as by-election candidate. Sunborn Hotel arrives in Gibraltar. GSD welcomes tobacco ban. Westside School extension inaugurated. And finally, Newton Creative Awards art category prize giving. Resurfacing at the political forefront for the first time in 13 years, GSLP by-election candidate and successful local lawyer Albert Isola this morning officially signed on for the election of the Parliament building. Presented to the press as the old friend of the party and a member who had since left Parliament in 2000 to focus on his law firm and growing family, been an essential player within the party during 2007 and 2011 general election campaigns. During what was described as an emotional and extraordinary meeting of the entire GSLP family yesterday evening, Mr. Isola's bid as candidate for the party was backed with an overwhelming response. Speaking to the press this morning, leader of the party Fabian Picardo insisted that this was a by-election that the party wished they had not have to contest, not because they fear the election process, but because of the sad circumstances that brought about the vacancy of the seat. Speaking to YGTV about why he chose to make his return to politics now as opposed to during the 2011 general election, Albert Isola noted that this was a question he had been pondering over the past few weeks. He explained that at this point in his life, the family law firm could run itself without him, and he added that politics was in his blood. The Sunborn floating hotel arrived in Gibraltar this morning. These pictures taken early this morning show the Sunborn on a large transporter ship approaching the detached mall. The floating hotel will now spend some time in the dry docks undergoing some final works before being moved to Ocean Village, where it will serve as a luxury hotel. The GSD has welcomed the government's announcement that it will ban the sale of tobacco in certain government estates. The party says that it is clear this activity has been on the increase in Gibraltar over the last year, due to economic recession in Spain. The opposition also stated that it was disgraceful that the chief minister should have chosen the announcement of this measure to blame the previous administration for the current state of affairs. A spokesperson said this is very much another instance of the blame the GSD culture, which the chief minister has personally become so fond of promoting, insisting that the leader of the opposition has been pressing the government to act on the issue of sale of tobacco in government estates for some time. This afternoon, Education Minister Gilbert Ligudi formally inaugurated the Westside Comprehensive School Extension, a project which spans both the former and current administrations. The £1.2 million 500 square metre block includes two new state-of-the-art kitchens, an additional classroom and a seminar room, workshop and purpose-built dance studio. The new studio has allowed for the school to teach an additional dance GCSE. The minister took the opportunity to thank GJBS for the work carried out on the school. Minister Ligudi visited the classes in action this afternoon. He was joined by Education Director Joey Britos, as well as Head and Deputy Head Teachers of Westside Comprehensive, Dr. George Garcia and Mr. Charles Lugaro. And finally, carried out every year in an effort to encourage the local community to use technology to get creative, the Newton Creative Awards yesterday saw Joseph Comila win the over 17's first prize for the art category. Prizes were also awarded to Marlene Mifsud's class in Notre Dame First School within the under 13's category. Janice Sambere won first prize within the under 17 category. This year's winner received either an iPad mini, an iPad fourth generation, or a 13-inch MacBook Air. YGTV spoke to winner Joseph Comila and Newton store director Cyril Dominici for more information on the winning entry and why the competition is carried out.
Well, the entry I decided would be a different slant on water. I had already had, which I'd done on my iPad, a seascape, and I thought, well, that's just run-of-the-mill. Let's try and think of something different. And I thought about the chemical symbol for water, which is H2O, And that's where the idea came from. And I started to develop that through a word program, you know, putting the letters into three dimensions, rotating them, giving them different lighting effects and so on, repeating them, resizing them, making different clusters out of them and putting them into different layers so that you could see from far away right up to the very highlights of the water molecules, as it were, coming through.
Well, we want to encourage people to use their computer for something artistic, creative, and see what they can do.
That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.